Hello. In this video, we'll show you how to install Milvus, a wonderful open-source Linux Foundation-governed vector database. Specifically, we will demonstrate how to install it on Google Kubernetes Engine. Taking a look at the project's public source code on GitHub, we can see that it has over 20,000 stars under its belt, making it a popular option among open-source vector databases. Being a Linux Foundation project and having graduated means we can put our trust in the governance and development of this open source project. Google Kubernetes Engine stands on the shoulders of the open source Kubernetes project, which itself boasts a very mature and widely used base with almost 100,000 stars on GitHub. This robust foundation is a perfect match for our vector-based AI, ML, or data platforms. For this installation, we'll be using the Helm chart to install Milvus, giving us a plug-and-play approach with the flexibility to tweak settings as needed, allowing us to tailor our Milvus installation. With all that said, let's dive in. First up, we need to create a GKE cluster in the Cloud Console. Make your way to the Kubernetes Engine and enable the API. Now that the API is enabled, let's create our cluster. By default, Google Cloud suggests an autopilot cluster, which is easier to run, but is more opinionated and controlled. For a deeper level of flexibility, we'll switch to a standard cluster. When you consult the prerequisites for installing Milvus, they'll recommend the number of cores and RAM needed for a standalone or clustered installation. We'll showcase the straightforward standalone installation since it's easier on the wallet, but bear in mind that the same methods of installation apply to the cluster-based installation. Let's equip the node pool with at least 4 virtual cores and 16 gigabytes of memory. To cut down on costs, we'll maintain this cluster with the zonal configuration, but remember that opting for a regional setup may provide additional benefits like zero downtime control plane upgrades, albeit at a slightly higher price. Crucially, in our default node pool, we'll keep auto-scaling off and stick with a single node. Configure the machine size to line up with the suggestions from Milvus, approximately 4 CPUs and 16 gigabytes of memory should be fine. With everything set, it's time to bring our database to life. First, we'll connect to the cluster via our IDE. For this demo, we'll rely on the Cloud Shell. If you're using a local terminal, ensure that you've configured gCloud with gCloud in it or activated a service account, and that you have tools like the Helm CLI installed. Luckily, we get all these goodies for free when using the Cloud Shell. First, let's verify we can connect to the cluster by running a clusters get credentials command. Next, add the Milvus Helm repository. Then, we can execute the installation command. We're adjusting some values for the Helm installation, like disabling clustering for a standalone instance and setting Minio to standalone mode. Additionally, we're switching off Pulsar. Keep in mind that numerous other configuration points can be tweaked for our Milvus installation using the set flags or values file. Check the GitHub repository linked in the description for additional detail. In this demonstration, we'll stick to the defaults with the exception of the overrides already in place in the Cloud Shell. Fire up the installation command and check if the Milvus pod is spinning up. We can sanity check the installation by getting the logs for the Milvus instance. There are quite a few logs, but they are all at the info level and everything seems to be in good shape. Lastly, we want to ensure that we can connect to this instance, so we'll set up a port forward to the Milvus pod's port. We will use the 195.30 port on both our host and the pod. In a new tab, we can use the PyMilvus library to verify that Milvus is up and that we can establish connections. We'll keep it simple and use a Python interpreter to check this connection. Please note, if you're following along, that Milvus version 1 and version 2 have different module names. We will specifically need to use PyMilvus for the version 2 that we just installed. From there, we can validate the connection. We're able to list the collections, demonstrating that we have our Milvus system working nicely. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments section and we'll keep an eye on them. Thank you for watching and please enjoy responsibly.